When creating our videos, we never tire of being amazed at the variety of options for the development of living organisms. Over millions of years of evolution, a huge number of the most unusual creatures have appeared on Earth. But all their oddities are actually the result of adaptation to changes in living conditions. So, here's another portion of stories about the most unusual modern animals. Subscribe to the Age of Dinosaurs channel, and then you could be the first to know about the release of new videos. We also encourage channel viewers to be more active and express their opinions in the form of comments and likes under the videos. This helps in the promotion and development of the channel. Also, with your help, we'll be able to tell as many site users as possible about the evolution of wildlife. Peacock spider. Australia is the homeland of several dozen species of this unusual spider, and only one species lives in China. Like many Australian spiders, these animals are poisonous, but they pose absolutely no threat to humans. All of them are no larger than a grain of rice. We won't even feel their bite. But for those who are also small in size, these spiders are very dangerous. They have excellent vision, but only two of their 6 or 8 eyes see color. These spiders do not spin webs and hunt by jumping on their prey. Thanks to special hairs on their paws, they could feel the smallest air vibrations within a radius of 20 centimeters from them. Considering the size of the hunter, this is quite a long distance. The length of a peacock spider's jump exceeds its size by about 20 times. The prey of these predators, as a rule, are flies, grasshoppers, moths, and winged ants. But they do not miss the opportunity to eat their weaker relatives. They also have a brain large enough for spiders, but they did not become famous for their intelligence and cruelty. Male peacock spiders have very bright colors and perform stunning mating dances. This dance can last up to 50 minutes. The male's torment stops when the female pays attention to him, but if she doesn't like the dance, the exhausted dancer can simply be eaten. But even after mating, the female can snack on her partner. She herself, having laid her eggs, does not leave them for a minute. As a result, the mother dies of exhaustion. In general, the lifespan of a peacock spider is about a year. Imperial Tamarind. The jungles of South America are home to a huge number of different monkeys. Among them, tamarins, belonging to the marmoset family, stand out for their unusual appearance. In total, 10 species of these small monkeys are known. Each of them boasts some unusual external features. They could be colored white, black, or brownish-yellow. Some species of tamarins have reddish or golden fur, while others have a luxurious, almost lion-like mane. But the most memorable appearance is the imperial tamarins. They're the owners of luxurious white mustaches, eyebrows, and beards. It's believed that they received their name in honor of the German Kaiser Wilhelm II. He also had a bushy mustache. In addition to beautiful facial hair, these small monkeys are distinguished by a rather interesting structure of their families. Imperial tamarins live in groups of 10 to 15 individuals. The dominant position in them is occupied by adult females. By the way, they're also decorated with mustaches and beards. These females mate with two males at the same time. Caring for the offspring also often falls on male parents. Each group occupies an area of about 50 hectares. It's noteworthy that these monkeys mark their trees with special pheromones. It's also interesting that tamarins distinguish only two colors. This dichromatic vision helps them better see predators in dense foliage. The main enemies of tamarins are snakes, predatory cats, and birds. But mainly, the population of these monkeys is reduced by people who catch animals for sale. Anglerfish. Anglerfish are a type of deep-sea fish. These include more than 350 species in 18 families. Due to their unique appearance, anglerfish are called monkfish, or sea devils. The largest of them grow up to 2 meters and weigh about 60 kilograms. Anglerfish meat is considered a delicacy in many countries and is obtained commercially. These fish are widely known because of their unusual way of hunting. The fish have a camouflage color and practically merge with the bottom. Only a long process sticks out, glowing at the end. Marine inhabitants, attracted by this light, themselves practically go into the mouth of the predator. Interestingly, the anglerfish does not know how to estimate the size of its prey, and his jaws act like a trap. The fish can neither swallow its prey nor let it go. As a result, both the victim and the hunter die. Colonies of bacteria living in the fish's body emit a pale green glow. These creatures have long developed a mutually beneficial symbiosis, but anglerfish have other lesser-known symbionts. The fact is that the described method of nutrition and lifestyle is typical only for females. Male anglerfish are very small in size and look more like a tadpole than a monkfish. The meaning of their life is to find a female. The male attaches himself to his partner's back, and after a short period of time, their circulatory systems merge into one. Moreover, several males can live on one female at the same time. Their functions are reduced to performing a single task, fertilization of eggs. After the female lays the eggs, she leaves the spawning site. Otherwise, she may immediately eat her offspring. The male anglerfish, even after his death, does not tear himself away from the female. It becomes just another growth on her body. It's noteworthy that this method of coexistence forced anglerfish to completely abandon their immunity. This allows you to avoid rejection when circulatory systems merge into a single network. How these fish have not yet died out from some kind of infection remains a mystery. Venezuelan poodle moth. Few people would agree that insects look attractive at high magnification. Discovered in 2009, the poodle moth is a rare exception to this rule. His appearance is so unusual and interesting that most people simply cannot cause rejection. It's white and black in color, and its entire body is covered with fine down that resembles fur. So far, this representative of Lepidoptera does not have an official Latin name. It's most commonly called the poodle moth, or horned moth. At the moment, not a single specimen of this creature has been caught or described. The public learned of its existence from 6 photographs taken by a zoologist from Kyrgyzstan, Arthur Onker. It's difficult to draw any conclusions about the species and lifestyle of this moth based on its appearance. There are suggestions that they're relatives of butterflies from the bear family. They're also covered with a kind of fur, and in the shape of the antennae, the poodle moth resembles representatives of the cocoon moth family. It most likely feeds on nectar, like other tropical moths. Brazilian Yabiru. This species of stork lives over a vast territory from Mexico to Argentina, but they settle only along the banks of rivers, lakes, and swamps. A colony can number several hundred individuals, but only a few of them have nested in recent years. Yabiru form long-term pairs and build permanent nests on treetops. Now, due to human activities, the population of these birds is gradually declining. The Brazilian variety of Yabiru storks has a height of up to 120 centimeters and a wingspan of more than 2.5 meters. They weigh up to 8 kilograms. Their feathers are painted white. Their black head and neck are completely naked. The stork also has a red collar on its neck, but the main distinguishing feature of this bird is its throat pouch. Male Yabiru can inflate it and make various sounds. This bag is mainly needed to attract females. They, like all other storks, feed on fish and amphibians. Moreover, Yabiru are distinguished by great gluttony. Such a large bird must use cliffs or trees to take off. The stork can also take a long run, like an airplane on the runway. It's also very difficult for them to fly in windless weather. White leaf-nosed bat. When mentioning bats, most people probably don't have the most pleasant associations. These creatures don't have the most pleasant appearance and are associated with damp, dark caves and sometimes with vampirism. But white leaf noses are not like that at all. These fluffy lumps are more like plush toys, and they eat exclusively fruits. Their body length does not exceed 5 centimeters, and they weigh no more than 30 grams. They're distinguished by an unusual leaf-shaped growth on their muzzle. It's believed that this shape helps to better capture acoustic vibrations. The ears and nose of these flyers are bright yellow. This is due to the accumulation of large amounts of carotenoids in the skin of animals. Mice get this substance from the fruit of the fig tree. It's these fruits that leaf noses prefer to eat. In many ways, this puts them at risk of extinction. Attachment to one type of food can play a cruel joke on white leaf noses. By the way, females prefer to choose males with the brightest ears and nose as a mating partner. This color indicates that the male is healthy and full of strength. During the mating period, the male forms a whole harem. He protects them during pregnancy from the attacks of other applicants. Those who aren't lucky enough to have a mate live in a common group until the next mating season. Leaf noses are also distinguished by their unusual way of building dwellings. They find a tree with large leaves near the feeding site and make a kind of tent out of them. The mice gnaw the veins in the leaf folds, forming an original shelter. Up to 1.5 dozen residents can live under it. It's believed that the sun's rays passing through the leaf mask the white coats of bats, giving them a greenish tint. Also, some scientists suggest that the white lumps hanging under the leaf may be associated with fruit. We thank the viewers who watched this episode to the very end. You can learn more about other unusual animals and the history of their appearance from previous videos. They also talk about environmental problems and the relationship between nature and man.